a magnet, and the magnet, like, it's supposed to magnet your phone. Don't take your hands off the wheel while you're driving. It is supposed to magnet your phone to the actual mount, I suppose. Yeah, to the mount. That's what it's called. But yeah, it's supposed to mount, use the magnet to keep your phone held on to the mount. And the magnet is like this big, so it takes up a good space on the back of my phone. And instructions tell you to stick the magnet to your phone inside your phone case or in the back of your phone. But I have a Note 5 and my phone doesn't come apart, and I'm not about to stick a big magnet to the back of my phone. So what I did was I stuck it to the inside of the case instead of to my phone. So the first couple of days that I tried using it, you know, I stuck it to my mirror and did a couple of videos. It worked just fine. Today, I stuck it to my mirror and put the phone on there, and it just started kind of sliding and sliding and sliding. So I had to tilt it up a little, like they make the thing face, I guess, bend it up a little so that my phone didn't slide down. Then it kind of had, I mean, of course it wasn't level all the way, but it gave it a little more support. So it didn't slide very much, okay? So I just put it in my car just now, and it took me 15 minutes, you guys, to keep my phone, to get it to where my phone wouldn't fall off of this thing. And the only reason that it's not falling off right now, but I thought, my theory was that since the magnet was backwards inside the case than it was supposed to be, because it was facing the phone instead of facing the mount. So what I did was I took some tweezers and I peeled it off the phone case, and I stuck a really thin receipt paper to the sticky part, because I don't want to stick a magnet to my phone, okay? I don't want all that residue all over my phone. I like my phone, and I feel like that would ruin it. So I stuck the paper in there and I turned the magnet the right way, and still it slides and slides and slides. I should have just got a phone mount that like grips it. But I was like, yo, this is cool, innovative, and new. Let me get this one so that I can be cool. The only reason it's hanging on right now is because it's on the charger, but I have the charger cord. That's another theory. I thought maybe the charger cord hanging from the phone was pulling it down because it was twisting down that way. So I wrapped the cord around my mirror. Well, I put it around the back side of my rearview mirror, and it still was falling. So I just pulled the cord a little tight so that it would kind of keep it up a little bit, but now the other side's trying to keep on falling down, falling. I don't know where I was going with it. And I keep looking at the bottom of my phone because I'm used to the camera being flipped onto the other side. But not today. Turn some eyelashes, and it's raining, and we all know how I feel about that. But I had already planned on going today, and I have to work the rest of the week, so this is like my only time. My husband got off early because of the rain, so here I go. I get to look at the new Makeup Forever stuff as well, if they have it there. Saving the video I just made. I made it on my phone, and it's taking a good little minute to save. I'm really sorry it's going to be a 30-minute video, but who cares? It's featuring my cat. Well, one of them. Oh, I hate the rain. So where are you guys from? What do you guys do for fun? I like making makeup tutorials, but I don't think that's what I want to focus on, like, solely on my channel. I definitely will be doing makeup tutorials, tutorials, but I also like to do car vlogs because I talk to myself. But now I'm not talking to myself anymore, I'm talking to you guys! Yay! I'm sure my mom's gonna get on here and then send me a message. You better keep your eyes on the road. You better keep your hands on the wheel. Pay attention when you're driving. Love you, Mom. Shout out to my husband. Thank so much for supporting me in this YouTube journey. I know I haven't gone really far yet. Oh no, traffic. I haven't gone really far, but to me, it is really far. You know, I appreciate everybody that has subscribed or watched the video or commented. You guys are so awesome, and my husband is such a supporter in this. He shares all my videos. He watches them all every morning. It's so sweet, you guys. I mean, we, of course, aren't perfect. We have our problems just like every other marriage, but when it's good, you guys, it's good. And right now, it's good. And most of the time, it's good. And we have our moments, but I couldn't see myself with anyone else. So I just knocked the phone down. Sorry about that, you guys. Oh, I was hoping that I would have left in time to miss all this traffic. I hate being in traffic and in the rain, too. I downloaded YouKnow, but I'm not really savvy on what YouKnow really is. Do you guys go on YouKnow, or is that more fun than going lot like filming car vlog type videos? Would it be better for me to just go on YouKnow? Or I guess once I get a better following, you know, people that would actually watch me, is YouKnow like a community, like a whole separate community, or is it strictly linked to your YouTube account? Because I download sat down and looked at it, I guess because I just, you know, I haven't had any need to go live on YouKnow. My makeup looks pretty today. It's very, very minimal. I just did my face, and then obviously you guys can see eyeliner, lashes, eyebrows. No, not eyebrows. I like having good eyebrow days. It's 4:30 p.m. on a Thursday, and I heard on the radio that it is going to get under 30 on Friday, Saturday, and that makes me miserable. I'm cold thinking about it. Right now it's 47 and raining, which I'm assuming is why it's going to get so cold, but I cannot do winter. I know my winter is nothing compared to a lot of people's winters, but still, like, I can't survive. I can't. I need to stay inside where it's warm, and even then, inside sometimes it's not warm enough. You know, I have these crazy moments. Either it's way too hot or way too cold, and at my house, like most houses, one room is always way hotter or way colder than the others. That room would be my room. My room is always freezing. That might be because I leave my window open too, because at nighttime I get really hot. And my husband's the same way. We get really hot at night. So it's just easier and cheaper for us to leave our window cracked, especially during the winter time, than to leave the air conditioner running. Because believe me, we're those people who, if we're hot in the middle of January, we will turn the air conditioner on just to cool off our room. So we just open the window because it's a lot less, or a lot more efficient, I guess. Energy efficient, us efficient, money efficient. Just open the window. Also, that way the kids don't get frozen out of their room, because obviously it's freezing outside. It's cold in their room, but we keep our room shut off usually. You know, we keep the door shut during the day. During our door is always shut, even when we're not in there. So that's also to keep my cat out of my room, because he likes to go in there and dig into stuff and make messes, and like he climbs up the window curtains, and he has this rooting thing where he likes to just pull everything out, and I'll go in there and there'll be paper all over the place and blankets unfolded, and he's mischievous, so we have to keep our room shut to keep him out. So, but I'm almost there, so I'm gonna go ahead and get off here, and I'll see you guys soon. And I'll show you if I get anything off shut. Bye, guys. Hey, guys. this video uploaded tonight. It is Thursday night, January 5th. I'm hoping to get it up, but I have, for some reason, all my videos are taking forever to upload. Right now, probably the one I'm uploading now is because I'm using my data, whatever you want to call it. So it'll probably take a little longer on my computer. I think the reason why it took so long to upload last night is because my computer sucks. One, two, it was a pretty deeply edited video for myself. I added music and did a lot of fast forwarding, I guess. So it took a little longer to upload. So I'm really hoping to get this video uploaded so I can go ahead and announce officially that I'm going to be doing a giveaway. When I get to 150 subscribers, I'm going to be giving away, again, like I said, one of those small Smashbox palettes. I don't know which one yet, or maybe I'll just save all three of them and let someone pick which one out of the three that they want. And again, I'll show you guys what they look like when I get stopped. And then a pair of lashes. Again, I'm not sure which lashes yet. I bought a couple of Allure lashes. I have a couple of Sephora brand. And then I'm also going to be getting some drugstore brand to go with it. Of course, you'll be getting a high-end and a drugstore brand of lashes. And I'm sorry it's getting dark. I'm on my way home and it is dark. I just wanted to come on camera and to announce my giveaway and then also to rant a little bit. You guys, so I see a post on Facebook from my brother saying something along the lines of, I wish I could slap the taste out of your mouth. Now, he doesn't mean that literally, or maybe he does, being the situation, or given the situation, excuse me. And, you know, me, nosy, I send him a message and I'm like, well, whose mouth are we slapping, you know? And I open up Facebook. And it's my first notification. I see whose mouth he wants to be slapping. And that mouth would be the mouth of my dad and or my stepmother. Probably not my dad, because I'm sure it's his doing. She's just the one doing it for him because he's not on social media. Now, backstory. My grandmother passed away 6 years ago now, almost. And last year, when my grandmother passed away, she was sick, okay? And she was probably the best woman that I know. You know, I know everybody has their faults, everybody has their things that people can say about them, but in my eyes, my grandma, that's what we called her, my grandmother, was the most wonderful, kindest woman that I know. She was my best friend, you know. I called her if I wanted to cry. I called her if I wanted to laugh. I called her good, bad, sad, happy, you know, whatever happened to me, even the smallest things. You know, she was the first person I wanted to call and tell. And she passed away. And my papa, you know, he became a recluse, really. You know, he stopped going out of the house. His health started declining. He slept probably 75% of his time. He was spending it sleeping. And before that, he was always outside. You know, he woke up and went straight out. So, yeah, he used to be like a, you know, just a, like your, what people think of Southerners. That was my papa, you know. He was a Southern man. He was outside 90% of his waking time. I mean, obviously, he was outside sleeping. You know, they were always at the camp at the river. He was always just doing something, you know, whether it be yard work or fixing something that didn't need to be fixed or fixing something that did need to be fixed. You know, that was my papa. He was always outside, always working, always doing something until my mama passed away. Now, when we were younger, My papa was a hunter, a fisher, you know, he took my brother, my cousins, all the men, the boys, they always went hunting and fishing. You know, it was just a thing when I was a kid. And he had a collection of guns and fishing equipment. And, you know, it was like I said, what you think of when you think typical Southern man. Guns, fishing, truck. Well, my mama had the truck, but well, it was there. But anyway, so he had guns that he had our whole life, all of our lives, and my mama had, I remember when she got this truck, it was a brand new truck, and she was so excited about it, and we used to go everywhere in this truck, you guys, like, we would drive to my great-grandparents' house, she would drive us, you know, that was just, she also had a van, but her truck was like, that was her thing, you know, we'd listen to Elvis, or Vince Gill, or, you know, other older music that my mama really loved. She liked to listen to older country, but her favorite was Elvis, and I remember she listened to Vince Gill a lot. And there's other songs that, you know, if I hear, remind me of her. But anyway, she had this truck, and when she passed away, my papa kept the truck, and eventually the transmission started going out in this truck. My papa kept it anyway. It sat in his yard for a really long time. His plan was to get it fixed. He was going to, you know, get the transmission fixed, get it tuned up. He was going to have this truck running again. Well, last year, my papa passed away in a house fire. It was an accident, but there was some stuff that went down, and it breaks my heart, you guys, but alcohol was involved. Not, he wasn't drinking, but from what I'm told, allegedly, because I know I have family that are going to watch this, they're going to get really upset at me, but it's the truth. There was alcohol involved in the toxicology report of the person that stayed with my grandpa. From what the detective told me, was off the charts. And a cigarette, from what the detectives told me, this is not my theory, this is what I was told, a cigarette was left lit in a room that my papa rarely ever went into. Now, it wasn't his cigarette. From what I've been told, it was not his. I stopped at a light. In the spotty. The house caught on fire, okay? They found the person. Sorry, that was my windshield wipers. They found the person that lived with them out in the yard, passed out. And they found him crouched down in the living room. And the way it was described to me was it looked like he was trying to get out and couldn't, so he turned around to go out the other way. And he didn't make it back out of the living room. And one of the things that was supposed to happen was my brother was supposed to get this truck. And there was a good amount of money left to their three children, and they got to decide what portion their children was given. But part of that, from what I was told, was my brother was supposed to get this truck. So, back to face slapping. The truck was posted on one of those Facebook for sale sites about 30 minutes ago. And, you know, I know that if we held on to everything that meant anything to us, we would never, you know, if this is anybody, we would have so much stuff. I feel like when things are promised to people, or when things are, you know, extra sentimental, they shouldn't be just sold away, you know, like it's nothing. And even prior to this, a few weeks ago, well, actually last week, one of my grandfather's guns was put on this Facebook for sale site. And it's just like, you know, the people that are selling it, gone through my own hardships. I've done some things that I'm not proud of, just like most people have. But the fact that these people, you know, not only are they living on my grandparents' land, which, you know, which is fine. I'm glad they have that land to live on. I'm glad they do, you know. But not only that, but now they're just selling off every piece of our family. That's our lives, our childhood, little by little. And I feel like, you know, what gives you that right? Because you're their child. Well, we are their grandchildren. You know, we should have some right as well. And I know that legally that's not how it works, but I mean, it's heartbreaking. And I know that I'm not the only person to go through this, and I'm not going through it. You know, it's my brother that was promised these things. It's not happening. You know, and I don't feel as if the way that it happened was fair, because we were all promised things that didn't happen. You know, and furniture and things like that. You know, that's just petty. You know, just stuff. And a lot of it got ruined in the fire, you know, a lot of it did, but then a lot of it didn't. And again, like furniture, you know, I would have loved to have some of my grandparents' furniture, but at the end of the day, it's just furniture. Things that, you know, my grandmother replaced probably once every 3 years, her furniture. You know, the only thing that I can say that was probably there for the longest was her dining room table and her china cabinet, and all of that was ruined in the fire. So, but as far as, like, things like my grandpa's guns, you know, why not see if another member of the family would be interested in it? Even if, you know, you needed the money, why not offer it before you just start selling it to strangers? You know, I understand everybody goes through hard times. I've been through hard times of my own, you know, and sometimes I still go through them, but to just sell off our history, you know, it's just sad to me to know that our childhoods and our past mean nothing but a dollar sign. And I know the reason behind it. I know why it's so easy to just throw these things away. I'm not gonna tell you guys that, right? You know what I mean? No offense to you guys. I trust you. It's just not something I'm comfortable putting out there right now. It breaks my heart. You know, I love these people, but I can't help but to feel some deep anger about this. You know, first the guns, and then now the truck. And it's just like, when are you gonna have some sense of family? You know, when are you gonna think about the rest of us? You know, because even these people aren't the only, he's not the only child. There were three children should have to decide whether they sell this vehicle or these guns. And you don't promise something to somebody and then decide that you need money because you blew through all of yours. Good to us, and now all it seems that matters is how much money you can make off of our history, or, you know, what other people can do for you versus what you can do for someone else. Again, I love them, but they just keep on surprising me. that break my heart. But we're going to stop this conversation. It's really sad. This is probably my first super deep video. Sorry. Super deep video. I'm sure it'll be one of many to come. But I want this to end on a happy note. Don't forget about our giveaway. Yay! I hope you guys have a really good night. Get me to 150 subscribers, you guys, and we're going to give some makeup away. Yay! I'm so excited. I hope you guys have a really good night. Again, let me repeat myself 10 times. And see you in the next one. Bye, guys.